Now, if you want to look at the tech side of the world, there are quite a few options which somebody can look, and some of you may be able to adapt or think in this direction, especially guide the next generation to look at that. I want to focus on how machines work, and if somebody is aspiring to become a data scientist or a more tech person, what they can look at it. So this is a very popular Venn diagram, which I always request people to take it as a self-reflection. If you are, like many other people who are thinking about becoming a data scientist, you have to really look at that and self-reflect and see where my action items to be become a data scientist. You need three, actually a few more, but the three core skills to become a data scientist. Number one, you should have decent amount of math and statistic capabilities. This is reducing as more and more commoditization is happening in the industry. You need to have domain expertise, whichever your sector may be, whether it is healthcare, finance, and whatever sector you're working on. And finally, you need to have some kind of programming skills. Now, this could be one person, and that person could be a sophisticated and high-paying job for data scientist. It takes a while. It's a journey which I advise people. Do not try to think you'll just be getting this all these skills in a few days, depending on where you are starting, or weeks even, months even. It could be years. But if that's what you aspire to do, you can slowly, steadily start building on it. Or it could be a team where somebody knows the math and the domain, and you get a computer programmer who is really capable of that and team up together to become a data science team. And people who have domain expertise is a very, very valuable asset in that sector. It's changing, evolving, but there's quite a lot of domain expertise value still in the system. And if you start...
Giving you a 4-minute warning.
Okay, thank you. We're almost there. And combining these things give you certain kind of capabilities. If you notice, having a mathematics skills and having the computer programming and coding skills give you becomes a machine learning person, but it's not a data scientist. A data scientist needs the domain expertise as well, because you have to really look in the scenarios and think about, oh, am I applying in the sense of true data domain expertise as well? What's the data telling me? What's the world telling me? The domain telling me? Rather than just what is the mathematical side of it. Math can be sometimes misleading. The numbers could be misleading in certain ways, or it can be drawn to a one-sided conversation or conclusion. And so you have to be mindful about that. And you can look into this interesting Venn diagram, and you could decide, I'm going to just be programmer and just start building my skills in the programming side. I could become somebody who is focusing in the domain. So I would give you a thought process and this Venn diagram as a tool to do a self-reflection and build onto it. Positive things. There are a lot of interesting, fun things happening, whether it is changing a black and white image to color, or providing the capabilities for differently abled people to drive or reach from one place to another, even blind people being able to really get to places without assistance from others, and so on and so forth. It's interesting options which are opening up. Situations in nuclear reactors or fire hazard or completely dangerous places where machines could be the first line of defense and help our firefighters and others. And of course, in medical science and so on. There is a lot of positive use cases and patterns which are coming in the industry. So it's not necessary, what I would say, a thing to be only worried about. Yes, there is concerns and things which you have to look out, and there are a few options which we wanted to share today. So with that, I bring to the end.